happy is the mother who bore you and nursed you?
Rather, how happy are those who hear the word of God and obey it?
Teach us to pray, just as John taught his disciples.
When you pray, say, Our Father in heaven, holy be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us day by day our daily bread. And forgive us our sins, for we also forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
In the Holy Scriptures, God declared the Messiah would come to be the Savior of the world. The life of Jesus gives evidence that he is indeed the one the prophets spoke about. Isaiah prophesied that the virgin will conceive a child and will give birth to a son. Centuries later, the birth of Jesus was the fulfillment of that prophecy. The Holy Scriptures declared that the Holy One to be born would be called the Son of God. This means that Jesus was to be called the Son of God in a spiritual sense. We see this in how he lived his life. He healed people from disease, forgave their sins, turned them back to God, and promised them a place in God's eternal kingdom. He offered himself as a sacrifice for sin in their place, and then rose again, conquering death. Jesus said, "No one can take my life from me. I lay it down of my own accord." The life of Jesus not only fulfilled the writings of the prophets, but also confirmed the truth of God's holy word. The prophets declared, "The word of the Lord is flawless. Your word, O Lord, is eternal." Jesus himself said, "Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will never pass away." Jesus came to give us life in all its fullness. But when man disobeyed God in the Garden of Eden, he chose to go his own way, and his actions separated him from the Creator. The Holy Scriptures declare that all have sinned, and the payment for sin is death. This means a spiritual death, eternal separation from God. But just as God provided a ram to die in place of Abraham's son, so he sent Jesus the Messiah to die in our place. His life, death, and resurrection restored the relationship between God and all those who put their trust in him. Now, those who follow Jesus not only have their sins forgiven, but are saved from God's eternal judgment. They are assured of paradise and will live with him forever. It is this life and freedom from the guilt and power of sin that Jesus offers each person today. This does not mean following a religion, but choosing to have faith in Jesus, who says, "I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come into him." This means turning to God and trusting Jesus to come into our lives, to forgive our sins, and to make us what he wants us to be. It is not enough to intellectually agree with his claims, nor to have an emotional experience. We receive him by grace through faith as an act of the will. When people are ready to become followers of Jesus the Messiah, they may speak to him in a simple prayer. Perhaps you are ready now to open your life to God. If so, you may join in the following prayer to him, silently, in your heart. Lord Jesus, I need you. Thank you for dying on the cross for my sins. I confess and repent of my sins. I open the door of my life and receive you as my Savior and Lord. Thank you for forgiving my sins and giving me eternal life. Make me the kind of person you want me to be. As I become one of your followers. Amen. Jesus said about his followers, "My sheep recognize my voice. I know them, and they follow me." In order to experience the abundant life which Jesus promised, his followers talk to God each day in prayer and read or listen to his word. They tell others about him and meet regularly with those who love and follow him. Remember his wonderful promise. All power is given to me in heaven and in earth. Lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the world.
אשרי הבטן שנשאה אותך והשדיים מהם ינקת.
מוטב אשרי השומעים את דבר אלוהים ושומרים אותו.
למד אותנו להתפלל, כשם שיוחנן לימד את התלמידים שלו.
כשאתם מתפללים, אמרו, אבינו שבשמיים, יתקדש שמך, תבוא מלכותך, יעשה רצונך כמו בשמיים כן בארץ. את לחם חוקנו תן לנו יום יום, וסלח לנו על חטאינו, כי גם אנו סולחים לחוטאים לנו. לידי ניסיון אל תביאנו, כי אם חלצנו מן הרע.
先知很早以前就在圣经里写明，上帝要派弥赛亚来拯救罪人，使他们与上帝和好。耶稣的生平清楚地表明，他就是上帝所应许的救主。先知以赛亚在圣经里写道：“必有童贞女怀孕生子，这就在耶稣身上应验了。上帝的能力使童贞女玛利亚怀孕了，她就生下了耶稣。”正如圣经里的记载。 童贞女怀孕生子的这个奇迹是上帝给的一个记号，好叫人们知道这个婴孩就是弥赛亚，他是上帝的儿子。人们看到耶稣，就看到了上帝的形象和能力。耶稣赦免人的罪，医治病人，拯救人，使他们能进入他永恒的国度。 耶稣献出自己的生命，替全人类承受罪的刑罚。三天后，他从死里复活，战胜了死亡的权势。耶稣说：“我有权柄舍弃我的生命，也有权柄把它拿回来。”耶稣的生平正和众先知在圣经里对弥赛亚的描述一样。的确，耶稣是上帝的道。 通过耶稣，上帝向这个世界显明他自己。耶稣说：“天地都要废去，我的话却不能废去。”起初，上帝创造人，好使他们能够幸福地生活在上帝面前。但是，人不听从上帝。 违背上帝的命令就犯了罪，罪就把人和上帝分开了。圣经里写道，所有的人都犯了罪，罪的结果就是死，因为上帝是圣洁的，所以罪人不能活在上帝的面前。正如上帝预备了一只公山羊替亚伯拉罕的儿子死，上帝同样派他的独生子替亚当的后代死。他这样做好使那些相信耶稣的人能重新回到上帝的面前。使徒彼得说，众先知所说的就是耶稣，他们说凡相信他的人，上帝必赦免他们的罪。因此凡相信耶稣跟从他的人，就会逃脱地狱的刑罚，并且能够在天国里和上帝永远地在一起。耶稣从死里复活之后，对跟从他的门徒说，要奉我的名到世界各地向人们宣告，凡认罪悔改归向我的人，上帝必赦免他的罪。耶稣还说，他要派圣灵来和跟从他的人在一起，教导他们真理，给他们能力，使他们能够遵行上帝的道。当一个犯罪的女子承认她的罪，开始跟从耶稣时，耶稣对她说，你的罪被赦免了，因为你相信我，所以你得救了。耶稣说，当一个人真的相信上帝，说明他的罪已经被上帝赦免了。耶稣叫人跟从他。当耶稣被钉在十字架后临死前，旁边的一个罪犯信了耶稣，并且求耶稣救他。耶稣回答说，今天你必定和我一起在乐园里。凡愿意跟从耶稣的人，可以用下面的祷告来开始恢复和上帝亲密美好的关系。上帝啊，你是公义的，谢谢你爱我。我违背你的命令，犯罪得罪了你，我很难过。谢谢你派你的儿子耶稣为我死在十字架上，后来从死里复活。谢谢你让耶稣为我所犯的罪替我受刑罚。我愿意跟从你的道，我愿意接受耶稣作为我的救主和我的主。谢谢你赦免了我的罪，让我能够和你永远在一起。我求你赐给我你的圣灵，和我在一起，向我显明你的道。求圣灵给我能力，使我能全心全意地爱你，使我的生命蒙你喜悦。愿世界各地的人都来赞美你。阿们。耶稣谈到跟从他的人说，我的羊知道我的声音，我认识他们，他们也跟从我。跟从耶稣的人每天都和耶稣谈心，学习耶稣在圣经里的话，他们学习耶稣的榜样，和其他跟从耶稣的人聚集在一起，还告诉别人耶稣是谁和耶稣怎样救人。耶稣升天回到自己的宝座前曾说，上帝已经把天上地下一切的权柄都给了我，你们要确实地知道我总和你们在一起，直到世界的末了。跟从耶稣的人应该牢记耶稣的这个应许。